السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد, our topic of today is about why don't we see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in this one we have prepared some of the questions that it can drive us to the topic of today, like how could we understand darkness if there was no light? How could we understand the day if there was no night? How could we understand the ilmu, knowledge, if there was no ignorance? How could we understand the value of Jannah if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not have given us the gardens in this dunya so that we can compare and not that one in the hereafter? These things, they are comparable. You can compare them because they are creation. But now you cannot compare Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah subhanahu mawla azza wa jalla doesn't have any comparison. Allah doesn't have quantity. We can't regard him in terms of quantity, quality with other creation. That is why we cannot have that vision of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have just seen many people who have tried to associate or embody some of their divine gods, giving them woods or giving them stone to reach to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But now Allah himself, he cannot be seen. And this evidence is not only found in the scripture, but even in our daily life. For example, if we see Quran chapter 6, verse 102 to verse 103, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has told us that it is clear no one can see Allah subhanahu mawla azza wa jalla. And this is the evidence from Surah Al-An'am, whereby Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said that ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ خَالِكُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ مُحِيط وَكِيل. That is the verse whereby Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us to show that we cannot reach him and we cannot see him. That is 102. And 103, it says that لا تدركه الأبصار وهو يدرك الأبصار وهو اللطيف الخبير ذلكم الله ربكم. And now the second verse, now it brings us to our discussion. The eyes cannot perceive Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The eyes doesn't have ability of framing Allah and understanding him. وهو يدرك الأبصار, but it is Allah who perceives the sight and who perceives the eyes of people. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the evidence from the Holy Quran. Also, if we can go to the Torah, it also has the same words that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot be seen. From the book of Exodus chapter 33 verse 20, it says that God is saying, into bracket, God, but he said, you cannot see my face, me God, for no one can see me and live. This is the evidence that comes from the Torah. Not only the Torah, even in the Bible or the Gospel, also in the book of John chapter 1 verse 18, God has says that no man has seen God at any time. No man has seen God at any time. All this prove, all this scriptural evidence proves to us that no man has ever seen Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and no one has ever seen how Allah. Now, we have those people who have struggled to show effort, to strain to understand or to see God, to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just like me and you, we're asking ourselves, who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How does Allah look like? Is Allah embodied like us, or who is he? So this question is in the minds of everyone. But we fail also to understand that we have some of the things that we agree with them, even without seeing them. Like, for example, you have the force of gravity. If you can go where there's no force of gravity, you can experience difference with what this force of gravity is. But we understand it is there, even without seeing it. Or where there is oxygen, like here, you can breathe well. That breathing only tells you that there is oxygen. So we don't need to be told, but we don't need to see, but we believe it is there. The same to human beings. We have among the prophets whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used them. like the chapters of the Holy Quran to make us understand this concept about seeing God. An example is the example of Musa alayhi salam, who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in Surah Al-A'raf, verse 143 of Quran chapter 7, whereby Nabi Musa alayhi salam, after he went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks to him at the mountain. And after the speech with Allah, Nabi Musa alayhi salam asked himself the same question I'm also asking, that why can't we see Allah? Can I see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So he asked Allah directly, that Allah, can I see you? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded to Musa alayhi salam that Lan tarani, you will not see me, but look at the mountain. If it should remain at its place, then you will see me. But if that mountain is going to move, it's going to shake, then know that you cannot see me. Then the mountain shook and then it became to dust. He told to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, exalted is you, my Lord. I have repented to you and I am first of the believers. So he now believed that he cannot see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is Musa alayhi salam. He requested to see God and God assured him that you cannot see me. Also, we have our beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. We all know in the year 620 to 621, that time when the Prophet, peace be upon him, was called by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during Isra wal Mi'raj. The Prophet, peace be upon him, he reached in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the company of Jibril at the place called Sidratul Muntaha. Sidratul Muntaha is a tree that is found between the heavens and the earth. And when the Prophet, peace be upon him, reached there, Jibril remained there, and the Prophet proceeded to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the Prophet reached in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet found himself prostrated before Allah. So, did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The answer, so qala Imam Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah fi sahih Muslim an Abi Dharri radiyallahu anhu qal, سألت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم into brackets حينما رجع من المعراج هل رأيت ربك يا رسول الله ثم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم نور رأيت نورا وأنا أراه. Sheikh Ibn Qayyim narrates, when the Prophet returned from that journey of Mi'raj, Abu Dharr asked the Prophet, Ya Rasulullah, O the Prophet of Allah, Hal ra'aita rabbaka? Did you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your eyes? The Prophet said that, Nurun, I saw strange light. I saw strong light. Fa anna arahu, how could I see Allah? So the Prophet did not see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet explained to us why he did not see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Listen, the Prophet said that, Inna bayna Allahi, إن بين الله عز وجل وبين خلق سبعين ألف حجاب. That the difference between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and us human beings is a difference of 70,000 veils of light. Like the Prophet continues by saying that وأقرب خلق إلى الله عز وجل, and the closest creation before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, جبرائيل is Jibril, wa Mikala and the Mikail, wa Israfila and the angel Israfil, wal Israfil and the Israfil, those three angels, they are very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that closeness and that distance between them and that veil, there is only four veils of light that can hinder them from reaching Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hijabun minan nar, there is number one, a veil of fire, the veil of darkness that prevents them. Wa hijabun min al-ghamam, and we have the hijab, the veil of the cloud that is covering Allah and them. Wa hijabun min al-ma, and the veil of water. So those are the obstacles that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given. And alhamdulillah also for the human beings, for the normal me and you, we have those things that we can do to drive us closer to Allah and to reduce this number of veils. Like that ilmu, knowledge, of trying to seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That knowledge only is also one of the way of breaking that veil. That iman, believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is also a veil. You are also breaking that veil. So also among us human beings, we have various veils that are going to bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And according to most Muslim scholars, they have the reason as to why we cannot see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are many reasons as why, almost 6-7 reasons why we cannot see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by our eyes. So what are these reasons that will bar us from seeing Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala? Number one, we cannot see God is because of our human weaknesses. What weaknesses? Because our sight is very poor, is not created to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our sight is only created for this dunya, but beyond this one, we cannot see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So because of this weakness, we cannot reach that rank. And specifically the eyes of us human beings. Imagine someone who has been possessed by a jinn. You can hear the voice, but you cannot see it. This shows our incapacity to see. But now, before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will give us rank when we go back to Him, and we shall be able to see Him in the next world, inshallah, if we work hard for Him. Also, seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's a very big achievement. It is joy. It is happiness. It is blessings. It's an achievement, and it's the reason for our creation to be with Allah and to see Him. Who doesn't want to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So, and because of this one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved that time for the day we shall meet Him, for those who believe. Like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that, إِذَا سَأَلْتُمُ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ فَاسْأَلُوهُ بِالْفِرْدَوْسِ. If you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask Him for Firdaus. فَإِنَّهُ أَعْلَى الْجَنَّةِ. Because Firdaus is the highest of the paradise. وَإِنَّهُ سَقْفُ الْجَنَّةِ سَقْفُ عَرْشُ اللَّهِ. And the Firdaus is the saqf of the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those who did good things in dunya, they will have Jannah, and they will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The third point why we cannot see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing us to believe in ghaib, to believe in things that are not visible, to just hear from His Prophet and to believe in Him, and to be loyal and to be sincere in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like in Quran chapter 2, whereby Allah has said that الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَيُقِيمُونَ صَلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. So in Quran chapter 2, Allah has said that ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. You believe there is God, though you have not seen God. You believe there is Prophet Muhammad, though you have not seen him. You believe in the day of judgment, though you have not experienced it. So now, also seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is something we have to believe without seeing. So it is only to justify that this thing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also among the tests that we have to strengthen our belief in Him. Like for example, a good teacher will have his students. He will tell them that whoever amongst you will work hard in his exam and pass, I will give him reward. Okay? But if a teacher says that, if one of my students works hard in class, I will give him 50 shillings. Maybe out of these students, we have those who are capable of getting more than 50 shillings. So they will say they will only work hard to pass exam, but not because of that promise. But if the teacher hides that reward, he said, I'll give reward, but don't show them. Okay, the student will be working hard because they don't know what the reward is. So the same to us. We're only asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us that light to see Him in the end time, because we don't know how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala look like. So we only know Allah through His attributes. We only know Allah is Ar-Rahman. Whenever we see Rahmah between creatures, whenever the chicken feeds its chick, we notice Rahmah. We see Allah Ar-Rahman. We see the attribute of Allah there. Whenever we see a sick person who is coming back to life, someone who has been infected maybe by corona and he comes back to life, he comes back to his health, we have seen Allah is Shafi. And then we can see the attribute of Allah there. When we see people dying, we see that Allah is the Mumit. When we see people who are turning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we see it is mu'min, as-salam. All these are qualities of Allah, and we can only see Allah through His qualities, but not in the vision of our eyes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also, we cannot see Him because to avoid mockery from the people, from the disbelievers. And also to increase more expectation from the believers, to avoid that mockery from the people. Because you can imagine some of the religion whereby the God is seen. The God maybe is something like an idol somewhere, or maybe some creation or a calf. They can see it. That one is, can increase mockery among people. But for us Muslims, we serve, and because of the respect of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we cannot see Him by our eyes as we yearn to meet our Creator, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Beloved Khalifa, Sayyidina Ali prayed to Allah by saying that, Ilahi, O my Lord, grant me competence, grant me complete severance of my relations with everything. Grant me that permission to leave everything else, and I submit to you totally. Oh my Lord, enlighten my eyes of our hearts with the light of their looking at you only, and to extend that they penetrate to the veils of light and reach the source of grandeur, and let our souls get suspended by the glory of your sanctity. This is the dua, and it has a lot of meaning that Sayyidina Ali prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the light starts in your heart, deep inside. And that light, which compasses with the knowledge, it reaches the rank, and it makes you come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to reduce this number of veils till in the end time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I take this opportunity, my brothers and sisters, to ask you to turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to ask Him to make our hearts to learn about on how we can submit to Him and to reduce that number of light that we can reach Him. Afa minkum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.